Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Joining us right now is an award-winning bartender who is helping us celebrate World Bartender Day. Please welcome superstar mixologist Tiffany Berrier.
Yes,
welcome, yes. welcome.
Thank you.
I am a fellow master mixologist. I've been doing it since 2012. Hello.
Yes.
Hail to the queens. So, how long have you been mixing drinks, and what is your favorite part of the job?
I feel like I've been mixing drinks since I was about 6 or 7, making drinks for my parents.
Okay.
Fix that, grab that.
Yeah, fix that, grab that.
Professionally, 15 years.
Oh, okay. What's your favorite part of doing it?
Seeing the people turn up.
What?
I feel like a maestro. I watch people go from to
All right, but
watching the vibe.
And see, a lot of people don't understand that it's a true craft because you want people to enjoy the drink and not be too sauced up to where you just can't enjoy the taste and the flavor of it. So explain that part of being creative and being a mixologist.
It's all about balance. Of course, we want to have that feeling, but we want to taste the cocktail, have levels, sweet to sour, salty, obviously boozy, pretty, tall, short. You know, you kind of wanted to match your vibes.
Yes.
So the balance is everything.
All right, well, we're going to vibe this out real quick, fast in a hurry. So tell us about Queen's Delight.
Queen's Delight.
Yes.
So I had the pleasure, Medieval Times invited me out to create some awesome cocktails. Medieval Times way out in Lawrenceville. Super corny, super fun. You get to wear these fun crowns. But they honored me for National Bartender's
Day.
It was great to just give a little extra energy to the fun and the jousting, but also add the cocktails and the fun to it. So Queen's Delight was just a kind of a play on what the queen would have in the 11th century, which she was only drinking brandy. But
and what is World Bartender Day?
So bartenders are really a social being to everything that we're doing.
Okay, so let's mix while you tell us.
Yes. So bartending is something that we do socially. Mm-hmm. We are part of the social environment all over. And people drink for two reasons, something good or something bad, hopefully something good. And us being the therapist at the bar, part at the bar, is super, super valuable. So that means a lot to me. Humanity is something that's coming back around full circle. Mm-hmm. Being a woman behind the bar, 60% of bartenders are women.
Yes.
We have that feeling. We know what to do.
That's
we kinda
right.
know how
that's
to
right.
have that nourishing. So, that's what we're celebrating, the craft and also the job.
And you were talking about Medieval Times, and you have a partnership with them. So talk to us about that now that came to fruition.
Yes, there's over 10 locations across the nation. Mm-hmm. And, there's a lot of wine, there's a lot of beer, but there's not enough good cocktails. So getting a chance to craft some really fun cocktails for them is right up my alley.
And what's Falcontry? What's that?
Falcontry, oh my goodness. So Friday I had a chance to goof off and make these cocktails. Well, tequila seemed to work a lot, which makes people fly. But there's some really cool animals along with a big falcon that flies as well. I'm just giving this a mix. I did some peach, a little bit of triple sec inside. We've got obviously a lot of spirit. Thank you, bar back. I appreciate your support.
Now, did you use alcoholic or non-alcoholic triple sec? Because you can find one or the other.
I went two ways. So not everybody wants to have a cocktail, and that's safe. Water is good. Non-alcoholic cocktails are good.
Yes.
But you don't always have to have water. What if you had, something with a little lime or a peach or something sour?
Well, but like you said, everybody doesn't do the whole cocktail thing. So they do mocktails, which is still a cute little drink in a cute little glass.
Absolutely.
Without the alcohol. So we just did this and it was called what?
This is called the Queen's Tale.
The Queen's Tale. I'm gonna leave that one alone. But you also do a mocktail called Tale of Six Nights. So
yes.
Tell us why you named it that and tell us the whole story behind it.
So,
while you create one.
So the theme itself, Medieval Times has six nights.
Okay.
They are all honoring the queen. It has been 35 years since they've even honored a queen
at
Medieval Times. So I'm like, these guys get a cocktail, but also they're fighting, they're at war, so I'll make it a mocktail.
Okay, so what's in it?
So it's really simple. Pineapple juice always wins, but if you add a little lime juice, there's kind of a little story that goes along with it. So I'm doing pineapple juice and lime juice, mixing that up, and pouring it right into the glass.
Is that the lime juice
That's
there?
That's lime juice, fresh lime juice, not that, that stuff
not,
you see.
Not roses.
Not that stuff. We're not
going
to talk about that.
And
some fresh pineapple juice.
Ooh. It really smells good. It smells really, 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 really good. And then you're just gonna add some ice in there?
I'm gonna add some ice and I'm gonna top it with ginger ale.
Okay.
And we're gonna keep it
cute. So while you're finishing that up, we're gonna take a quick break. And I know my sister Selena and Quad will wanna get in on these cocktails and the mocktails when we come back. Stay with us. All right, we're all back with master mixologist Tiffany Berrier. And thank you so much for joining us, because I had a great time. Please make sure you follow Tiffany on Instagram at The Drinking Coach. All right, ladies, are we ready to try these cocktails and mocktails?
I have a cocktail with extra vodka.
I'm telling you.
And it's delicious.
Look
yes,
in the eyes. Look in the eyes.
Girl,
oh, look in the
so
eyes.
Good. This is so
yes.
good.
It's refreshing. And it's not so sweet. Mm-hmm. That's what I like about it.
That's what we want. When we say balance, that's important. People are very used to saying, is it sweet? Or I don't like it. But if it's sweet and sour, like we like our food,
that's what
it's
this
a balance.
Is.
It's
you
like
can
a
taste
sweet
the grapefruit
sour.
Juice in it, too.
Good.
But
good,
it doesn't
good,
take
good.
Away from the pineapple.
It's enjoyable,
it's
but
really
not
good.
Too strong.
And that's
refreshing.
Refreshing.
That's how I like.
Easy
I feel
peasy.
Like I should be
easy,
somewhere
like
in Trinidad with
Sunday
Rashawn.
Morning.
We can imagine that right now.
Well, Rashawn, we miss you terribly, mm-hmm. and we're going to save a sip for you.
I'm not saving it.
But to Rashawn, we will see her very, very soon, but not yet. But we thank you guys so much for joining us today on Sister Circle Live, and we will be back tomorrow.